We all love sharks. From a distance.
As I'm sure most of us have seen while watching Shark Week or Jaws, sharks really depend on their mouths, so their teeth need to be really good at what they do.
Despite what you might think, not all sharks have the classic Jaws dentistry, though. In fact, shark teeth are incredibly unique, coming in all shapes and sizes, adapted for the environments they find themselves in.
And today, we'd like to show off some of our favorite sets of shark teeth and put them to the test.
Yeah, with power tools. We thought it would be fun to test the cutting ability of a few different shark teeth by attaching them to an electric saw and then just cutting stuff with it. For science?
For science!
For science!
Here we've got a collection of real shark teeth from four different species and a bunch of victims. The saw should mimic the head shake of a large shark cutting through its prey. Many sharks shake their heads when they caught a fish, because the way their jaws are structured, they aren't actually able to chew their prey.
Yeah, and just so you know, this same experiment was also done by Cornell researchers in 2016. So it's kind of ridiculous, but probably legit. But let's be honest, this thing is mostly just about cutting stuff with a shark tooth saw. I can't wait, this is gonna be awesome.
Okay, so let's start with the great white shark.
Let's do it. Okay. I'm trying to match the speed I think a shark's teeth would actually go.
Okay. What's happening? Look at the jelly.
If this is a fish, it's not having a good day.
Well, how do you know what speed to put it at?
This is my first time doing this. I don't know about you.
This somehow is supposed to mimic the actual jaws of a great white shark.
Right. And so I think part of that makes sense because as a shark, you know, grabs its prey, the prey is going to be fighting back, it's going to be shaking, and then these serrated edges to the teeth are probably going to do a little bit of cutting.
So this action is supposed to be head shaking?
Something like that.
There are clearly big holes in our experimental setup. For one, we have no way of using a consistent speed on the saw, and we can't replicate the shark's different attack methods. It just seems to me like, hey, this is a cool idea. Let's justify this with science.
That sounds pretty good to me. Yeah. Let's do it again.
Okay, but it's my turn. We accepted the flaws of this experiment and set out to test how the shape and sharpness of different shark teeth might impact how quickly they're able to cut through a thick, fish-like gel. 3, 2.
Time. 8:66.
Check out that bite, though.
That's very cool. Unsurprisingly, this tooth shape is very efficient at slicing through the gel. But what about the teeth of other species?
You're really excited about those teeth.
Yeah, the tiger shark.
Okay.
The shape and serration, or, you know, the jaggedness of tiger shark teeth seem to be specifically suited to eating hard-shelled prey, like sea turtles and other tough animals. They've even been found with metal cans and burlap sacks in their stomachs. So their teeth are pretty tough. These ones are really quite sharp to the touch. I feel like if I applied even a little bit of pressure, it wouldn't take much for it to puncture my skin. Mm. And on top of that, it's serrated just like the great white teeth are. So I think it's just gonna sail through the stuff like hot knife through butter.
Well, tiger sharks are known to be pretty vicious.
Yeah, let's put that to the test. Let's do it.
Okay, oh, I'm starting to sweat. All right, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, well, this is interesting. And the
really?
Time for the tiger shark was half the time. So now I want to compare the cuts.
Okay, what do we see?
I see like almost a wavy pattern.
More of a pattern with the tiger shark.
Yeah.
This just looks like it's kind of random.
Next, we wanted to try out a very different set of shark's teeth. These are really small.
Yeah.
These come from the sixgill shark. Sixgills have been observed in head-shaking behavior while eating, but it's thought that they likely restrain their prey and swallow it whole. So these teeth should have a different effect on our victims than the other two sets.
3, 2, 1. Oh, okay. He's struggling.
Okay, so that was about almost 10 seconds, pretty slow.
All right,
to the top
speed. But it made it.
It made it.
In the paper that inspired this experiment, the researchers noticed that the sixgill's teeth didn't dull as quickly as the others. This could be because sixgills live in colder environments, which slows down their metabolism, which in turn slows tooth replacement. So their teeth need to last longer than most other sharks because it takes longer to make new ones. The last teeth we wanted to test out belong to the nurse shark.
And we've got nurse shark and tiger shark here. What are the differences you notice?
Yeah, well, the nurse shark we know is a very different shark.
Yeah.
They like to spend a lot of time on the bottom of the sea. Mm-hmm. You can go scuba diving with them.
Yeah.
They're pretty docile. And they eat in a different way completely. So they tend to suck in their prey, which are like shells or crustaceans, smaller creatures, and crunch.
Right. And you can see the teeth seem to be a lot more sort of flat. They're not, there aren't really any of those spikes that we saw on the tiger shark.
Yeah.
So
way smaller.
Yeah.
Less wide. But you're right. They're not very sharp at all. Three, two, one. Super struggle.
Yeah.
Like he can't even.
Yeah, I gave up.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
Did he go through?
It made it through.
Okay.
And the time was 14:53.
Whoa, check that out, though. Very different.
Oh, that's cool looking, actually. I think part of it might have been that, with the gel, once you get a tear in it, it tends to
It starts to go on its own.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So the great white shark cut in 8.6 seconds. Our tiger shark is crushing the competition with a time of 4.9 seconds. The sixgills slowed it down with 9.9 seconds, and the nurse shark cut through the gel at a measly pace of 14.5 seconds.
All okay. Right, what do we have left?
What we have left is perhaps the most terrifying option of all the teeth we've come across so far.
We've done great whites, we've done tigers.
Yeah.
What's left?
We haven't done human teeth. Yeah, we'll see what.
Human teeth.
So human teeth obviously aren't terrifying normally, unless you glue them to a saw blade and then it gets a little bit weirder. But it's pretty awesome. I want to see what happens if we compare human teeth to shark teeth.
I think this will be really insightful because we know that people don't chew the same as sharks.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, if you're kids, maybe some of them will bite and thrash, but they're not really designed for the same kind of aggressive.
Tearing. We're all about chewing.
Yeah.
I'm gonna bite first. Cool.
This is by far the most absurd scientific experiment I have ever tried.
He's really having a hard time. This is definitely our longest time, like by far, right? Oh, it's gonna suck. Okay,
I think I think we're through.
Oh my.
And so that, ladies and gentlemen, is what happens when a human bites through gel. It takes about 38 seconds. Congratulations to our species.
Pathetic. Come on, if we really were going to take a bite of this stuff, we just would never, right? You would probably just chomp right down. Please do it.
Oh, yeah. That's pretty easy, actually.
Yeah. You should spit it out.
It tastes worse than you imagined.
But this is cool because we get some teeth marks now. We have real human teeth marks.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which are nothing like the teeth marks that we just used with this saw. So you, my friend, have done something great for science today. Thank you.
For science.
Yes.
So what did we learn? We learned about the size, shape, and durability of a bunch of shark teeth.
Yeah, we also learned how important it is to plan to control your variables if you're hoping to learn anything from your science experiments. Oh, and also that a shark with human teeth would probably starve. Thanks for watching.
That is really foul. Everybody else made it seem not so bad.
Okay. I lied.
That's pretty bad. For science.
For science!